Second, so this is a little review courtesy of Mixed Mag Magazine about the Body Movement Festival that happened a few weeks ago, right? And about how successful it was and all that good stuff. And I think I mentioned it before on my podcast before, right? About how cool it was to see all these alternative club nights and festivals and stuff pop up over the last, what, 18 months, it feels like, as a response to, I think, as a kind of weird response to this kind of constant conversation that happens about having, not enough variety on the lineups in terms of genders and sexual orientations and backgrounds and whatnot. Instead of complaining and whining and moaning about this stuff on social media, a lot of people have decided to kind of gather their resources, their friends, their local community, and actually do something about it themselves and put on these really cool events that, for the most part, from what I can see, have been very, very well received by the public and have been a resounding success within that little niche. And you're hoping that, as time goes by and people become more aware of these little subcultures and groups and niches that exist within dance music that kind of form the overall kind of tapestry that makes this such a beautiful and rich sort of scene, that more people will get kind of hip to it, and it will kind of progress to the point where these people will also be on the sub big lineups where they're paying you 10 grand per gig and shit. Because that's where we're going to get to. Because as great as these events are, you also want to see some parity in terms of the levels of pay and all that stuff going forward. So this is courtesy of Mixed Magazine. Body Movement Festival was a landmark occasion for queer self-expression. It says Hackney's Body Movement Festival, the first queer electronic music festival, is a landmark occasion taking place in early October, with the festival season shifting into autumn by a late reopening of nightlife. The sold-out event, founded by DJ Sarosi and Little Gay Brothers Clayton Wright, features 20 collectives, 16 spaces, and an astonishing lineup of DJ performers and artists. A rush of sweet sensory overload is felt upon arrival by body movers in anticipation of the day spent reveling in music, dance, hedonism, and laughter. Arriving at the ticketing area of the festival, the celebration is immediately feels special. The sunlight reflects off the shining clothing, garments worn by the festival goers, blah, blah, blah. Beats are audible in the distance, dissonant sounds bouncing off each other. One pair embrace and declare the excitement to be able to dance together. For those attendees, body movements embodies have something greater than the festival. I was told, so it's a gay club culture is left for the nighttime. Okay, let's review that again. For some attendees, body movement embodies something greater than most festivals in the calendar, bringing together their queer identities, friendships, and love for dance music. Gay club culture is left for the nighttime, I was told by someone I met at a bar. Well, hello, I'm here. I'm in the sun, showing off my legs. I'm ready to go have a good time. I'm tired of waiting until dark. It's like waiting in the shadows. Despite being October, revelers show skin soaked up in last summer rays. That's actually interesting, because I remember listening to one podcast once where people were talking about club culture and about, obviously, it's foundations in the queer scene and whatnot, especially in the gay club culture. And some girl popped up and said she finds it sometimes annoying and frustrating how there aren't a lot of club nights or clubs that are more catered towards the lesbian side of things. And it got me thinking, to huh, that's interesting, because I wonder if, like, on the same side of gay guys saying, hey, we don't feel comfortable in going to like straight bars, so we got our own little scene where we kind of feel comfortable doing our own little thing. But then also, you have to imagine a lot of the gay clubs are sort of seedy, I don't say seedy, but they're kind of, mostly catered to the nightlife. They're mostly catered to kind of after dark hours. And you wouldn't imagine a lot of the guys that go to gay clubs will be that comfortable going to some of the big marquee festivals that exist, because it's a very bro-y energy, right? These kind of marquee festivals. There's a lot of girls, there's a lot of guys, but it's a very, what that term they say? It's a very cis straight sort of vibe in general. There's not a lot of kind of queer camp vibes when you go to a normal festival. So maybe when you go to like a kind of, a general everyday sort of festival. So maybe it does make sense for these festivals to exist, because they are kind of one of only a few options available, where people from the queer scene can go and celebrate in that kind of sense. Because obviously, when you go to places in Europe, mainland Europe has many daytime festivals, where you can go as a queer person and have fun and obviously feel comfortable. But I think in England there is a little bit of a, there's a little bit of a gap in the market, and I think that's where maybe these guys have maybe decided, and they've kind of obviously been able to hit out of park. It says here, yeah, this is what Hackney Wickeds used to look like, so the one is East London local attendee. This isn't what it used to look like. Well, it's true. This is an interesting thing about Hackney Wick. This is a very good point. Hackney Wick has changed. Like, think about, let's think about it this way. If you've been to the Colour Factory, right, that's in Hackney Wick, that used to formerly be known as Mixed Garage. I'm pretty sure the people that are programming Colour Factory are not the same people that used to program Mixed Garage. So it's the same space, just different people have taken over it. And it seems like they're very much going for whatever the opposite of mixed garage was. So the entire area, because for the most part the yard was the kind of alternative space where a lot of the kind of alternative nights were kind of being held, you know, and then the kind of conventional club nights were mostly being held at Mix. But now Mix is sort of doing, now the Colour Factory is doing both at the same time. They're still hitting at the park with the kind of conventional, you know, A tier, B tier DJ nights, and they're also doing all the little kind of alternative nights that kind of speak to a niche, and they're doing it at a very, very, very high level. But also it's kind of bringing an entirely different energy to that little kind of Hackney Wick space, which is great to see, because there's loads of little bars that have popped up during lockdown as well. It just gives that place a rich sound. So by the time you're jumping off the train, the overground at Hackney Wick station, and you're walking down and you're kind of perusing and trying to decide where to go, there's just a general great visual stimuli to see as you're kind of perusing around, like people wearing different clothing, different colors and creeds, sexualities. It's just great to see. It's a far nicer place to be in terms of a night out than it was maybe prior. It's still as good, don't I think. Yeah, I won't say better. It's different. Let's not say better. It's different. I think both have their pluses. It says here, we've also seen loads of these businesses suffer, so it's nice to have organizers are not leaving them out. She adds, in reference to 16 Hackney Wick venues hosting various collectives. He, she, they, Sophia Kearney says, the same as we stand in the dark and hand and sway to the beats played by Wax Wings at the Lord Napla Star. Wax Wings and Sophia both cherished an amazing occasion following that there have been a tough year and a half. It's nice to be able to see people have free reign over their day, their choice and activity. Her statement rings true. People have full autonomy to attend whatever event that they want and listen to whoever they want. Seems like a perfect personification of what the day represents, coming together after lockdown to be free, unite and listen to music. And again, you can't be mad at that, and that's the beauty of a London club night. Look, all these different people from all these different walks of life just enjoying themselves and having an absolute jolly good time. Founder Clayton Wright says he felt both fear and excitement when planning and hosting this event, noting that there's a lot of pressure to get this right because of the sheer amount of people that he feels obligated to represent. I just want to make people happy, he says. Collaboration and solidarity is what I want to achieve at the end of the day. Clayton is keen to hear my perspective as a young queer person with limited experience in the club Raven Festival scene, and wants to ensure that people like myself can use the event as a learning experience too. Oh, that's great to hear. DJ Service mirrored a sentiment during a conversation at La Teresa, showing that there are several acts present who she herself has not seen and that she's excited to check out and learn about as opposed to just on Instagram. I'm just glad we're here and we've got to make this happen for this reason. And that's what I think, again, is the beauty, I think, of what's happened. I think because there's been such a negative reaction to like the general club scene and the festival lineups and all that stuff, what's been going on, gender line, blah, blah, blah. I think because there's such a visceral anger at not being represented, because again, maybe I'm coming from a different point of view being a DJ and I've seen how hard that is to be, but it must be really frustrating and somewhat rage inducing to see yourself not being reflected in a clubbing space when you know there's a lot of people like you that also are on that dance floor, to not you see yourself represented on the, you know, in the large scale on the lineups, and also not being represented in terms of parties being catered directly to you. So to finally get somebody that kind of makes something that is specific to your needs and to your area of interest is something that you're definitely going to jump all over and be on. So I definitely understand in that respect. So big up them for actually answering the call and just doing the damn thing instead of complaining about it. Because again, the complaining thing on social media is easy and something that kind of comes naturally to a lot of people because that's what these platforms are basically there for. But in my experience, or from what I feel, or personally, I don't think they're constructive or helpful in any way, shape or form, because these people they're complaining about, these big organizations, these festival lineups, these clubs, they don't care, right? They're only gonna don't get twisted, sooner rather than later, when this sort of stuff starts to make big money, all those big festivals will suddenly start to care about these people that are playing in these lineups, right? They'll start to suddenly want to promote diversity. They'll suddenly start having topless guys with nipple piercings on their flyers and shit. They'll start doing it for sure, but until it doesn't make money, it doesn't make sense to them. So if anything, instead of complaining and shouting into the void, just do your own thing, set your own stand, and then what you can do by building your own platform is that you can then dictate your terms when those guys come calling. You can say, hey, okay, if you want to book me, this is my terms, here's how much I want you to pay me. I want parity with the same other people that are playing as well. I want representative. I want it. Basically, you can go in and start being, you know, just strong arming them and saying, if I'm playing, I want a girl before me and a girl after me, fuck it. I mean, just some straight fuck shit. You can do that once you've already proved the concept and you've obviously got your own thing going on. I think, look at what Possession have done. Say what you want about some of their other stuff that they've gotten up to, but in terms of proving a concept, they've proved the concept of their little niche, and now they can kind of go in and just walk into a room and just kind of dictate terms, because they're the ones that are bringing the party, they're bringing the reputation, they're bringing the name that already carries a bit of weight. And I think these guys can do the same thing with their Body Movements Festival, I think, going forward. What's that? News that Daytime is one of London's most spoken about collectives in 2021 are taking over Old Street Brewery spreads. The dimly lit venue is packed with Daytimers, regulars, and showcases a colorful set by Anu and a fun free back to back by Gracie T and DJ Pri. Again, people I've never heard of, so it's fucking great to see. Featuring South Asian classic samples and cheeky bangers remixed. Anu sports a dupatta representing her South Asian heritage at a festival of queerness. DJ Pri and Gracie T, longtime Instagram best friends, tell me that they've been at Body Moon Festival is the second time they've ever met in person and their first ever back-to-back experience. The DJs proudly wear cultural clothing, spend their day exploring the other stages, all while getting to know each other in real life and having a boogie over the yard courtyard where Big Dyke Energy had packed up the space. You can't go wrong with that, innit? Just imagine that, visually seeing this, right? Seeing these South Asian artists wearing their cultural garments alongside Big Dyke Energy stuff. Like, it's just, this is what you want to see. And again, they're doing it on their own accord, not screaming and shouting at these big festivals to represent them, proving a concept, and then obviously build up from there. So it's fucking great to see, man. So again, big up Body Moves Festival. I'm not going to read the entire thing. You can check it out yourself. I'll put the link in the show notes for you to see. But again, this is what I love about the club scene now in London. It's so rich, so vibrant, so many different people that go out now. It's not just the same old tired heads, and this sort of stuff is also being plopped up on the same platform as all the other stuff. Do you know what I mean? It's not just the same old tired people and tired flipping, you know, promoters and all that stuff and lineups that are being propped up. It's good to see. It's just fresh, it's new, and out of this we're going to have some new stars, some new people to kind of look up to, people to kind of, you know, rally behind and all that good stuff. So I'm really, really for it. So yeah, big up Body Moving Festival. Wishing those guys and girls more and more success in the future, innit?